Hi, I'm Dr. Janine Bowring, naturopathic doctor, and today's topic of discussion is sources of EMFs and what you can do to counteract those negative impacts of EMFs on your health, or EMR, electromagnetic radiation. So EMFs, of course, is electromagnetic fields, and we are inundated on a daily basis with this electromagnetism from the outside, which of course is synthetic, it's not natural, it's man-made, and it has a negative impact on our cells. So for more information about what it does and the potential dangers of EMFs, check out my other videos, and be sure to like this video, share it with your friends, and be sure that you're subscribed to this channel and click the bell so you always get our newest and latest uploads here on YouTube. But also leave your questions and comments below. I would love to hear from you what your opinions are on EMFs and if they've affected you, because I've spoken to hundreds of people that have had negative impacts on their health due to EMFs, and we've been able to help to educate them at turning things around so that they feel better and get more healthy. So one of the most obvious ones, of course, is cell phone exposure. So we know, especially now with the 5G technology, there is definitely a correlation with, you know, having a negative impact on our health, even in the legal terms of your cell phones. If you read the fine print that, you know, the warnings are there for that RF. So the radio frequency, the exposure that we have to these electromagnetic waves. Now, one of the things that we'll do, I'm gonna have my crew call me in just a second here, they're gonna call in on my cell phone, is I have an EMF reader, and certainly there's a lot on the market, and I'm getting my call. Here we go. And now that my EMF reader is on, we can actually see that this is sending my EMF reader to go into the red, which is never a good sign, and that has that cell phone exposure. So one of the things that you can actually do is to make sure that you never put the cell phone up to your head. Do not take calls like this. If anything, you're gonna keep it as far away from your body as possible and put it on speaker phone. And so that it's not close to your body, try to limit your use and the length of time that you are on a cell phone. If you need to use earphones, the air buds, so the pods, those little pods that you put in your ears, not so good. Again, they're amplifying that electromagnetism. And think of it, there is one in each ear, and they have to communicate with one another. So they're sending that signal right through your brain. Not a good thing. If you absolutely have to use the AirPods or the Bluetooth, it should only be in one ear. I highly, you know, caution you against using them. There's something called air tubes. So the air tubes is something that you can purchase, and they're definitely better because they do not have a wire. But if you need to, you can use a wired headphone, which is a little bit better. Certainly not the best, but it's better than certainly holding up that cell phone signal right to your head, to your brain. So the other thing is Wi-Fi. So Wi-Fi is everywhere, and one of the things that you can do with your Wi-Fi router, if you can, is to turn it off at night. So we know that as we're sleeping, this is, you know, a big chunk of our day, and so especially if we can decrease that exposure when we're sleeping, that would be one tip. Another tip would be to create a Faraday cage. So a Faraday cage is basically a metal encasing. We'll do a future video on how to do this in the future, but basically you can make a Faraday cage to encapsulate your Wi-Fi router to protect yourself from those EMFs. Now, another thing is microwave ovens. So this one is probably one of the first things that come to mind when we talk about EMF exposure, and the microwaves definitely have, beyond just the, you know, the distance of the microwave and the outer casing of the microwave itself, but far beyond that. And I read one report that said you should stay at least 100 feet away from a microwave oven that's on. So yeah, that's pretty scary. And when I did my own RF, you know, reading in my home, when we did have a microwave, because I was curious, and even standing about 10 feet away from it, this was still picking up that radiation. As much as we think that we're protected because the door is closed, we're not protected. So get rid of your microwave. Nobody really needs a microwave, in my opinion. And what you can get is a steam convection oven. And so it uses steam, works much like a microwave. You may be adding maybe 3 to 5 minutes to your cook time, but it's incredible in how it heats the food. The quality of your food doesn't get dried out. So it's a great way to you know, not have to use a microwave oven in your home. Baby monitors. Now, this is one that is, you know, a lot of people just have no idea that the wireless baby monitors are irradiating your baby. And is there really a need for a baby monitor? I never really used one, to be honest. I had four babies. And it's not something that, you know, definitely everybody has different levels of comfort in terms of, especially if it's your first baby and you want to make sure that they're monitored, but you could be doing more harm than good by using the wireless baby monitors. So if anything, if you absolutely need one, try to find a low EMF baby monitor and preferably something that's wired in and not too close to the baby and where the baby is sleeping. Another one would be smartwatches. And rings now, which they have to measure, you know, your physiology and what's going on for health reasons, but the watches also give off EMF. So if you have to use it, absolutely you can use it. I tend not to use and wear mine, nor do my kids, because, you know, of this newer information that I gathered on EMFs and the effects on health. But if you have to wear it, put it on airplane mode. So that means you won't be receiving calls from your watch, but put it on airplane mode. That will help to protect you, or if you have one of the rings as well. Now, when we're talking about mouses and computers, so definitely if you've got a wireless mouse, this can be a problem again because of that signal that it's having to send between the computer and the mouse. And laptops as well are notorious for giving off EMFs, and it's right on your lap. Should not be on your lap. I mean, this is something, again, that you have direct exposure, and the closer you are to these devices, the worse the exposure. So there are ways to protect yourself, protective blankets and things that you can use to decrease that risk, but try to keep, if you need to be on a laptop, try to keep it, you know, away from you. Try to have it wired in if you can, and with internet as well. Internet should be wired if you can with Ethernet so that you do not have that wireless exposure and those signals bouncing off between your router and your device. Another one is that, you know, you may not realize hair dryers have a huge amount of EMF exposure, so we can't even dry our hair anymore. Then, you know, so the best thing to do here is to maybe air dry your hair as much as possible, let it dry naturally. And then if you, at the last bit of drying, if you need to use a hair dryer for a short amount of time, you could certainly do that. But, you know, to use it for a long period of time is probably not the best thing for your health. Induction stoves also have a lot of EMFs, so try to go with gas if you can in your home. And your clock radio. So if you have an alarm clock that is in your bedroom, certainly I hope it's not wireless, so make sure it's the old school type that is doesn't have any kind of Wi-Fi or wireless, you know, component to it, but try to unplug it and use batteries within the radio so that, again, there's not that EMF exposure. And another one on the homes is smart meters. So smart meters came into the world about 10 to sometimes longer ago, 10 years ago, and this is something that you may not even realize that you have a smart meter, so go and check on the side of your house. And typically if you're you know, your usage in your home for your hydroelectric is monitored, so there's certain times of day, that's in where we live in Canada, certain times of day are less expensive, you know that that's a smart meter, or else how else would they know? But that gives off and uses Wi-Fi, so that is giving off EMFs yes into your house. And certainly the closer that you are to your smart meter. So if there's a bedroom in the house or an area of your house where you spend a lot of time and that's on the other side of a wall of a smart meter, you're at more risk for that EMF exposure. And in another video, I talk a lot about the symptoms. So headaches, nosebleeds, and all these things, the lack of energy, dizziness, that can be related to EMF exposure. So be sure to check out that video as well so that, you know, you can start to put two and two together as to why maybe you're not feeling well, or maybe you've manifested a certain disease And we have another video on that as well, on the correlations, what the science has shown us and has proven in terms of the correlation between EMFs and our health. So thanks for joining me today. I hope that you love this video. I hope you learned something new, and leave your questions and comments below. I would love to hear from you. Be sure to like this video, share it with your friends, and I will definitely love to, you know, have that interaction with you, and we'll see you next time.